hello everybody, this is Oldtoby back, exactly where we left off, pretty much. Looking at horses, contemplating going into this biz. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and go in. Oh, I was gonna eat. Let's have some beef jerky. I think that's a little bit more nourishing than the other stuff in Pam's that I have with me. At first I toyed with going around this way, but I think I'm just going to go through. Let's just go through and take a look at it. I love this biome, so we're going to see how the computer performs recording and going through here. Love it. So we're going to try and make this recording stuff a little bit. Woo! I'm trying to get more regular with it. We again are continuing to move northwards. Ooh, look at that. Look at all them trees. Wow, okay, I didn't realize it was quite that. So we're just moving northwards, kind of. I think we're going to loop back over this way. And then, if we continue exploring, we can kind of move in a zigzag pattern back down towards the other base. Okay. So let's make sure we're facing the right way. Yes. Okay, let's keep going. So it's probably going to be a little bit chuggy as we move through all of these leaves. I do like these trees a lot. I mean, I think if I wasn't recording, I might choose to live in this place. I find it very peaceful and nice and good. Okay, so Kathy, I'm going to finish the story now. All right. I realized while I was editing video yesterday, I realized that I started telling a story, and then that kind of big aqueduct ruin happened, and I stopped telling the story. It's not that big of a... It's not... You may not even think it's all that funny, but... And I think it actually happened to my sister, but I've told the story so many times... Excuse me, I forget who it happened to, but I'm pretty sure it happened to her. You know how that goes. Sometimes you tell a story, and over time, for whatever reason, you kind of appropriate it. It's not, you're not lying. Ooh, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. I see you. Oh. Look at that. So nice. But you kind of appropriate the story as happening to you, even though it may have happened to somebody else or somebody very close to you. And I think I've told it from that perspective before. But it's not true. It happened to my sister. She was, the Perkowiz story, she was babysitting my older brother's kids. Her and her husband were staying with them while they left to go, they actually went to Norway, I think. They were gone for like 10 days or something. It was really cool. They got a chance to go spend some time overseas. So, she was staying with the kids, and there was one day where, let's go ahead and grab... I'm going to take a cup of coffee here while we're waiting for the sun to come down. Oh, I do that all the time. I move one thing thinking it's the thing that I need, and it's not the thing that I need. Okay. Take a drink of coffee here. And I will tell you one thing that always occurs to me whenever people do that, whenever people take a drink of coffee or they take a drink of beer or whatever while they're recording or doing anything with a microphone, I immediately think about what their breath smells like and how they're blowing coffee breath into a microphone, and it always grosses me out. So now, there you go. Enjoy. I give that unto you. So they were watching the kids. We're just moving along here. Watching my nieces and nephews, and they... Ooh. No. Terrifying. It was late, getting late, later in the evening, and the kids were kind of starting to settle down. They wanted to watch a movie. And so they said, okay, go ahead and tell me what movie you want to watch. And I think the oldest kid was maybe, I don't know, six or so. And they kept saying, Perkowitz. I want to watch Perkowitz. And so my sister was like, I don't know what that is. Perkowitz. And she's like, what Perkowitz? And so the kids are getting really frustrated because they want to watch this certain movie. And they, of course, know exactly what it is. And, you know, Sarah's saying stuff like, well, okay, so what is it? How do you say it? Say it slowly for me. Perkowitz. And they were getting more and more frustrated and upset. And so finally they just started going through. Sarah just opened up, they had like a drawer full of movies. And they just started going through, pointing at each one. And it was Hercules. The kids were saying the word Hercules, but for whatever reason, when they said it, they were saying it Perkowitz. So that phrase, Perkowitz, that word has been incorporated into my family's kind of lexicon of weird words that we say. Loud ducks. And so there are times when I will just say it, you know, something about Perkowitz, and I forget that nobody else knows what that word means or what significance it has. So that's the story. It's no big deal, but I felt remiss. Ooh, hello, anglerfish. That I started the story and never finished it. So there you go, you got it. I kind of want to go up this. I want to go up this sheer cliff and take a look. Because there were anglerfish over there and I don't want them to eat my face. And this feels a little safer over here, maybe? If not, we can just kind of move around, at least move around this side. Oh, mud. I hate it. Okay. I don't like messing up the land, and I can't... Look at all this junk I've picked up. Alright, I'm going to drop this and this and that and that and that. I like the way it looks, but I see no reason for it. Oh! And I just picked it all back up again. Because this block refuses to let me jump on it. Alright, so... it looked like a horse. Let's eat. Swap this down, and let's throw all this stuff away again. God. Stop it. Hey, fish. Yes, usually I do my best to preserve landscapes, but I just kind of want to get up here and take a look. Okay, I don't need to actually waste the torches. Let's do it without thinking. Let me kind of make my way up here, because this is dull going. I will make my way up here, and we'll take a look at the top. Okay, hold on. And welcome back. Okay, so it took me a little bit, and I got up here, but I just noticed this. Little fishy witch hut down there. Fishy. Witch's hut. I barely ever see them in actual real Minecraft. Which I believe I've discussed once before on said video game. Okay, so here we are up top. This is kind of cool. Looks like there's a dark forest, dark oak forest. And I remember, I think I like this biome a lot. I like that color. But we're going to go down and around, but I saw this as well. This is really cool, kind of a natural hollow here underneath this hill. This is a place that I could see myself coming to live. I've done stuff like that before in the past. I think one of the live streams I did for early 1.10 snapshots, or whichever snapshot it was that introduced shields and stuff. Oh, I see you in there. I built a base underneath an outcropping like that, and it was actually really fun. It was a cool place. Okay, so let's travel back down on this opposite side here without dying. If I can find a cool place... Oh, man, I'm telling you, heights. Heights in Minecraft. Doink, and doink, doink, doink. Dip, dope. Yep, yep. Norp, okay. Hup, heap. Whew, okay. Let's get down and cross. Continue moving. Whichever direction this is. Yeah, nice. I like it. I don't like the mud, but I like the overall look of this. What is it called? This is just Land of Lakes. Marsh. I like it. I think I kind of like the brown color in the... and the grass and stuff. I cannot stand the mud. Oh, it's like one of my least favorite things in this pack is mud. I don't know why. Do 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 do. All right, I'm gonna cut out and I'll bring you back in when we see something cool. Because at this point, I don't know what to say. Alright, hold on. And hello, welcome back. We just slept, and I looked in the atlas, and it said there was a village here. I haven't seen it yet. There it is. Okay, cool. Yeah, because I just looked to see kind of where we were, because we're getting closer. We're going to cut over here in just a little bit. And it popped up on the map, and I was like, what? And so I was all, no, I don't talk that way. So yeah, I wanted to take a look, and I wanted you to be with me. Let's see what kind of cool biz is in here. Oh, don't. Let me come help you, friend. Hey, buddy. Where are you? Did you burn up? He burned up. Nice. Okay, so let's take a look. How do I get up here? Here we go. Let's see. What do we have growing here? We have coffee beans. Do I have coffee beans? I don't know. So let's at least get a row of coffee beans. This is beans. I know I got that. Canterbury. I know I got that. Cactus fruit. Excuse me, cactus fruit's kind of weird because I think it needs to be like rice or something. It needs to be in water, maybe? Or on sand or something crazy. Maybe the opposite of rice. That's just normal, I believe. Normal crops. Yes, just wheat. Okay, just a little wheat. I do like... Huh. Let's see. I don't really... Well, now I've got an emerald. I do have an emerald. Maybe they'll want to trade with me. Persimmon sapling. Oh, thank you. Gooseberry sapling. No. Let's check this. Okay. Punks. I've got that. Hey! For 16 onions, you'll give me one emerald. No, thank you. That seems like a terrible trade. Any more? It's just empty. What am I picking up? Here. Take it. That's just... yeah, potatoes and normal crops. Yep, all normal. Okay. Oh, I kind of like this. What is this? Just grassland. That's pretty. Ooh. Dangerous up in that biz. Okay, let's keep moving. Doo-doo. What is this? It's a big old cave. Yep, I like it. Okay, well, again, I'm going to cut out here and I'll bring you back in when it's time. All right. Well, it looks like we're moving into some ice here. Just looking again into the ocean there, see if I see anything. I'm not really seeing anything. We just came through one of those kind of dead zones there. And, oh, hello. Let's go down and take a look at that. But yeah, nothing much is happening right now. The biomes are, all ones that we have seen. So we haven't really ventured in. What is this? Yeah, we saw this once before. I feel like when I step into it, something should happen. Or some kind of noise, or... take these because I think they're cool. But that's pretty creepy. To be walking along and see this. What is... it's just road lines. Grimstone. Grimstone. Smooth grimstone plate. Huh. Okay, I don't... oh. Oh. Wasted pork. All right, let's go back up over here and oh, that's cool. That's good luck that I started recording right as that that biz happened. We're getting to the point where we're gonna turn to the left here. Or kind of go west, I guess. If that's the right direction. Whatever direction that is. We might actually start moving that way. Because I remember kind of where we spawned in the very first episode was next to the ocean. Watch out, the thorns. So there's a good chance that we may have to do a little bit of boating to get where we need to be in the first place. But I don't mind starting to curve that direction now. It's really pretty. We're getting close to needing to sleep. Don't attack my things. Man, I'm telling you, yesterday I was all, well, at least last episode, I was all talkative, and I'm a lot more sedate today than I was yesterday. Sleep. Sleep. It looks like it's sleep. There we go. But it's one of those things where, you know, I find myself just kind of wandering and looking. And just enjoying that so much. And, oh, not for sure. That's awesome. Hello, I don't, the creeper's not awesome, but... just want to see what's over here. Just more biz. It's always interesting. Sometimes when sand or things kind of blocks. When words fail me. When things are loading in, how they look like structures. That's what I meant to say. I go, okay. It's a good sign to end the recording right now for a little bit whilst I do some more just general traversing. And again, any cool stuff that happens, I will bring you back in. Okay. Hello, kids. It's almost nighttime, and we were boating, and I saw this place on like a little island. So let's take a look at this. This is nice. Looked very pretty from a distance. And don't break. Stop it. Go in here and sleep. Ooh, it's been the journey. What is this place? Let's drop the bed down. We'll sleep and then we'll check the place out. Okay. Let's see, what's in here? Witch Miner by Lurky. Huckleberries, elderberries, I'll take them. Oh, an enchanting table. Well, that's luscious. Another one. Enchanted book. Eternal compass. Looting. Nice. And I'll take those. Well, now. I don't need that. Interesting. Eternal compass. I've never heard of that enchantment. Black slab. So is this some kind of witch hut? It's cool. I like it. That's a really cool looking build. I like the little... that is nice. That black slab is really cool. Very nice. Okay, so we're getting closer and closer, kids. Wrong thing. Let's check here. So yeah, we're almost there. So again, I'm gonna cut out and I'll bring you back when we're closer. I think we're at the last two islands before we get to the coast that I originally spawned on. Because we've now joined up with where we had explored before, and so this little space here, I believe, is the island that I could see from my shore. So we're getting really close to the old place, and I kind of just I want to see it appear up on the top of that hill. It's gonna be awesome. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna sneeze. Please don't. Okay. So there's one of those places. Here we go. That's pretty cool. So this really is, yeah, see that torch? Oh, boink. That's basically my spawn point. I think. Amazing. Well, oh, there's even one here. Alright, let's head in and find this place. I think I remember exactly where it is. And it's weird. I've got this big, stupid, punky grin on my face. Ah, don't hurt yourself, friend. All the animals I didn't want to kill. Oh, so cool. Yeah, like I said, this is one of my favorite biomes in the whole game. These, the cypress or whatever the grove or cypress something. It breaks out into a plains, and then there should be a big hill, and then our house is up on top over here. Hey, there it is. Lovely. Lovely, lovely. So that was a journey and a half. So I think one of the things that I've been considering, and there's that big ugly tree, is trying to join the two bases through the nether with portals. Let's use this lower... See, and this is so ugly. I need to fix all that. And this is ugly. I could clean this out and do some stuff here. But this is kind of nice, huh? Coming back to the old stead, there's the old portal. Well, old home week. Storage drawers, things I left behind. Fragment of suffering. Oh, yeah, okay. Awesome. So many things I left behind here. I have so much inventory to get rid of. So good. Did I do anything with that? Oh, I just left charcoal in there. Fine. Let's take a look out here. The old garden. This is all tilled garden soil. Man, that's some work. I tell you what, do the work, friend. And then we go up here. See, look at this. Come on, this is great. We got a little carpet there. Oh, I took that stuff. I can reuse some of that stuff. There's a presser. What is this? I don't remember what that is. Yeah, presser. Any food in there? Loads of food. Food for days. We got the upstairs too. A little table and chairs. There's the bed, which I will now sleep in when it's time. And the roof and everything. Ah, nice to be back. Got that one. Nice to be back and see this place again. Sweet. So what I'm going to do is go down the stairs and take a seat. So what we'll probably do here, kids, is call this episode complete. And I'll probably just do some work around here, maybe get into some of the mods I haven't touched yet. I've done a bunch of exploring. I'm feeling a little bit more energized. We can jump back in and hopefully get deep into some of these mods I've never messed with. So I appreciate you guys being with me on this journey around. And real quick, I'm gonna go sleep. Oop, excuse me. Sleep in the actual bed. This one I won't break. So nice. So nice. So thank you so much for hanging out with me today, and I will catch you next time. All right, see ya.